Hello, people. Yes, this is JP Ronnie back as usual to bring you yet another demo disc. But as you can see by this screen, this is not a UK demo disc. No, this is Euro Demo France 24. Yes, now I actually got this disc from Germany, of all places. Yeah, I don't really get it. But yeah, most of the demos I got were German. But this disc also happened to be in there somehow. I don't really know how that works. But I wanted to look at it just to, you know, see what it's like, see if it's any good. And yeah, I mean, the interface is obviously pretty familiar. I mean, it looks, I mean, hell, it looks a lot like Demo 12 Volume 2, which I looked at before. Obviously, the games are different, because I think this was released in October, wasn't it? Actually, I think, we'll see, because I see Spyro the Dragon video, and I think that was on Demo 37, I think. But anyway, ignoring that, let's see what's on this. We have Circuit Breakers, Ghost in the Shell, ISS Pro 98, oh, I really don't look forward to playing that one. Oh no, I don't want to play this. Yeah, the Fifth Element, you gotta be fucking kidding me. Oh, hell, I'm glad they didn't include this on the UK demos until, like, you know, 2003. But anyway, Test Drive 5, Tombi, yes, I've really been looking forward to playing this one. I hope I get to play that in English, because I really want to. Everybody's Golf video, Spyro the Dragon video. Yeah, this had to win from October, because I mean these videos on here and Tombi's on this, so yeah. Pushy 2, which is a Nick Ross game, and Net Yaroze video. So yes, Circuit Breakers, let's do this. Sorry about that, I kind of had to open the door, because, I mean, I'm having the window closed because of all the noise that's outside. I don't want it interfering with the recording. But, you know, the room's so fucking hot. Yeah, here we go, Circuit Breakers. Actually, I seem to remember, weren't there two demos, and I seem to remember, like, the second one, which I think is the one that's on here, if I'm not mistaken. I mean, I assume it is. I think you can actually insert this disc, like, while you're playing that game, and you'll get, like, bonus tracks or something. That'd be pretty cool. Stupid dogs. Of course, it decides to bark as soon as I start recording. That's brilliant. I don't get, like, ugh, it's ridiculous. Anyway, English, of course. Oh, yes. So, this seems to be exactly the same as, you know, the disc that you get in the UK, which is quite good. I mean, I've played this game before. Actually, no, I want to go with the slimline car, actually. Let's go with that, because it'd probably be able to fit through the turns better. And I do remember this game, because I remember I used to play this demo all the time on, Demo 18 Volume 2, because I used to play that all the time. But, no, this is different to the other one, because I think that one was like a winter theme level, and this is, yeah, this is a different level. There's like a castle at the beginning. And you got the draw distance there, by the way, that's brilliant. Just see it all, like, fade in. Even though, like, the camera's, like, above you. That's brilliant right there. I don't remember Micro Machines V3 having that problem, so it seems kind of weird that this game does. Oh, no. I mean, I didn't own this game back in the day. Like, I played the demo, but I didn't have the full game. Because, like, I played, like, Micro Machines V3, and I played a few of these sort of games on, like, PS2. Like, Stunt GP. Which is a game I don't many people can... Oh. Of course, the opponents can take the power-ups, that's just brilliant. I mean, it makes sense, but it's still kind of annoying. And all of this, like, the opponents are just overtaking me left and right, this is brilliant. The music's not bad, though. I don't mind this music. I mean, it's not great, but I mean, it's all, I guess. Oh, give me that. Is that a speed boost, maybe? Oh. Okay, so now apparently I'm bigger. Okay, I don't get that. Like, why does it look like an up arrow and it makes you bigger? That makes no sense. And all of that, every single time we get to that pill, the opponent takes it. That's just brilliant. Final lap, great. Actually, this doesn't seem too bad. It's a lot better than I remember it being, anyway. No, get out of the way. You know why? Because I'm a rally. Oh, okay, that was not the best place to put that. Brilliant strategy brought to you by JP Ronnie. Okay, what's this? Oh, okay, so that's... Okay, why does that speed you up? Okay, why is... Okay, why does the speed up hill look like a bolt of lightning? That makes no sense. And surely it'd make more sense to have the up arrow speed you up, but whatever. I came third, so that's something, I guess. Yes. So that's... Yeah, that's it. And... Yeah, because I think there was... Yeah, the world... Yeah, Circuit Breakers presents the world's first add-on disc. You're on the full version of Circuit Breakers. You can have unrestricted play on all 8 extra circuits on the add-on disc. Yeah, so technically this demo is like an add-on disc for this game. And there's a few other discs, or a couple other discs, that have the same demo, which are... Yeah, Demo 37 in the UK. And Essential PlayStation Disc 9, I think. It was one of the discs that had it. And I like the icons on this, actually. They look pretty cool. But anyway, Ghost in the Shell. Now, this is a really good game. I remember I played this on Demo 9. I can't even talk now. I remember I played this on Demo 99, and it's pretty awesome. It really is an awesome game. It's basically, you know... I'll be honest, I haven't seen the film this is based on. I'm just going to say that right now. I haven't actually seen it. I want to watch it, because it looks quite interesting, but I just haven't had the chance to watch it. I mean, obviously, they never showed on TV. You know, I don't have DVD or anything. I don't know. Like, maybe it's on one of those, like, you know, video hosting services or whatever they're called. And we're just going to skip the intro, because I've seen that before. I don't know. If you really want to look at the intro, I'm sure it's up on YouTube. And I think they just took it from the film anyway, if I'm not mistaken. And I remember you can't actually select anything here. So let's just start the mission. I've got this game, actually. Because I did get this game. a few months ago, I think. And it's awesome. It really is. I mean, that. I guess I could say I kind of seen bits of the movie because of playing this game. Oh, okay, the cutscenes are in French. That's pretty cool. I like that. Actually, why is the text in English? That makes no sense. Like, I don't get this. Like, the voice acting's in French, but the game's in English. That's weird. Actually, I hope Tommy's in English, like I said, because if that game's in French, I'm going to be kind of disappointed, because I won't be able to read any of it. I mean, I can't remember what to do in that game, but still. Yeah, like I said, this game is awesome. I love this game. Yeah, so, yeah, like I said, you're a robot, you have to go around blowing up shit. Yeah, I'm not extending from the assigned area. What the hell are you talking about? So, give me up on here so I can blow up this helicopter. I think the helicopter's respawn if I remember correctly, but. You know, it looks awesome when you blow it up. At least it would do. Yeah, there we go. But yeah, basically you just gotta go around and just blow up all the, you know, big robots around. And I remember this guy's a pain in the arse, so I'm just gonna use the grenade on him. Cause, you know, grenades are there for a reason. And I've just got another one, but I'm probably not gonna need it. Oh no, I might choose it on the boss. Even though the boss in this game, or this level rather, is like really easy. Yeah, as you can see, all this, by the way, you shoot this guy and he blows up. Went to a Contra, actually, where, you know, you like shoot the enemies and they'd always like, they always just smash into pieces. Yeah, I always thought that really weird. Because how many missiles do I have? Because I know you have a limited amount, but I can't remember how many you start with. So there we go, key code acquired, time, oh, wait now. Yeah, that's right, there's another one, got a bit of that. So I remember one of the monsters? What the hell am I about? One of the robots at the end doesn't actually give you the code. I don't really get that. Seems kind of weird to me. Yeah. When you say GTA, when you bought the helicopters with a rocket launcher. But that game, oh bugger, I pressed circle X in. And didn't even hurt the thing, that kind of sucks. But why isn't this guy dead? I shot him like a billion times. I know there's some health around here. Okay, let me blow up this guy. And we shall get the health. Okay, and I'm just going to ignore you because I don't need to blow you up. And yeah. Just going to beat this level. Because, yeah, I'm going to say this right now, the Tombi demo, that one's going to take ages. At least if I could play it in English, it's going to take ages. Might as well use the grenades on this guy. Even though I usually don't, because... frankly, this guy is so easy, it's unbelievable. Just going to abuse the... ooh, he's using the missiles on me. Great. Actually, I'm not sure. Does he only do that if you use the missiles on him? I'm genuinely not sure. Ooh, I might just take a damage on this guy. That's pretty sad. And he's down. Yeah, I win. I do win because I'm awesome. Yeah, 137,000 points. That's what I'm talking about. So yes, that was Ghost in the Shell. Yeah, coming to some night. I get this, like I said, I mean, why is it that the voice acting's in French and yet the actual game itself is in English? That really makes no sense. But anyway, we're going to quit out of this, because, yeah, it just goes back to the top of the screen. You can't really do anything else, if I remember correctly, so... it'd be kind of pointless if I kept playing, so... let's just go to the next game, whatever it was. Oh, ISS Pro 98. Yeah, I said it before and I'll say it again. Really not a fan of football games. And I remember playing the ISS, one of the other ISS games, or IS, or whatever you want to call it, and getting pissed off at it because I couldn't figure out what to do. Yeah, okay. Yeah, so, yeah, I mean, this, I don't get this, like, you'd think, like, if they're going to make demos exclusive for France, they'll put all the demos in French, but I guess not. Because this seems to be in English. And, oh, controls, nice. Let's see, so, okay, the X button presses with the ball. Triangle plays the keeper, yes. Do you have to, I'm not sure, do you have to tap R1, or do you just, like, I'm not really sure. Okay, L1 changes player, that's useful. That is definitely useful. Because I always hate it when it just selects them automatically, and you can't actually select them. Okay, and squad and shoot, let's go with that. Okay, computer plays against self, good. Actually, I'm just gonna play against the computer, because I'm not sure, have I played this one? So I think I might play an ISS game on, that Best Sports Games compilation, but... I'm sure I've played this before. Yeah. Yeah, it is, because I remember, this is the same demo, because you get to play, because you play as France in this. And I remember, you know what's funny is, you would think that in the English version demo, you would play, you play as England or someone. Or maybe Italy or something like that. But no, you play as France in all versions of this demo, which is kind of weird. I mean, it makes sense in this version. But, yeah, it's like, even then, the game's in English, so it's like, what the hell? Oh, stop passing the ball. I mean, I know you're Brazilian, but still. Okay, so I think you hold the... oh, you twat. Now let me put the... yeah! I got to score this goal for... ooh. Oh, what the... oh. I pressed circle by accident. I'm going to press square. I don't know why I was trying to shoot from there, but I guess that's just one of the reasons I suck at football games. Oh, why is it that whenever I side tackle them, they just immediately pass the ball? It really sucks. I can't get the ball off them. It's ridiculous. Okay, now I've got the ball. Oh. Actually, I'm not sure. Are these even, like, the licensed players or not? Oh. At least I got a shot and goal. Okay, I really should have done a high pass. I think. No, they're gonna score because my defense has gone AWOL. Liam. He's passed his man. Yeah. Doesn't look that good, considering they missed. Square to kick ball. No, it doesn't do anything. Okay, circle. Okay, that's kind of weird. I mean, it makes sense. I mean, it's like high pass, so. Ooh. It's kind of annoying that it doesn't show like what play you're about to pass to, like in FIFA. It's not really much of an issue, but still, it just kind of bugs me. Oh, here we go. Oh, and I just ballooned out of the ball. I will say this is one of the better football games I've played on these demos. I mean, it's alright. Actually, I'm not sure. How do you head of the ball? I'm not sure what button. I don't think it's set at the beginning, so. Okay. Let's see if we can at least get another shot on goal for the end of this half. Oh, okay, so square heads the ball, okay. I think they eventually. Passes are spread around well. Oh no, that was a terrible hit. It really was. But at least I'm not gonna lose while that swings. There we go. Oh well. It's alright, I guess. Oh no, it's not really. I really can't say it's a bad game. It's just, you know, like I said, they're not really my sort of games. It's quite good for its time, I suppose. Your ISS. I know there's like a Nintendo 64 version that people say is really good. But now we've got to endure the piece of shit known as the Fifth Element. Yeah, I mean, I remember I said last time, yeah, when I played, you know, Eurodemo 86, that the controls in this game are absolutely terrible, and they are, okay? The game sucks ass, and the controls are pretty much the worst part of it. So, presuming this is the same demo that I played on Eurodemo 104, and actually, I'm not sure, was this video on it? Because I genuinely can't remember. I don't think it was. Might as well have a look. I mean, I'll be honest, I haven't seen the film. It's a bit of a running theme here. Games based on films I haven't actually seen. And, I mean, I've heard the film's good, but I haven't seen it, so, yeah. But I remember, like, trying to play the full version of this, and it sucked. It really does. Like, I kind of know how to play it now, but it's still, even when you know what you're doing, it's still awful. Because, like I said, the controls are awful. They are, I mean, I'm not sure if you'll be able to tell from this, but they are ridiculously stiff. In fact, yeah, no doubt I'll be warning about that in a bit. This video goes on for a while. Oh, actually, please tell me this is just a video, and I don't have to play it. Because that would be, I was about to say that would be sweet, but I didn't actually have to play it. Because, like I said, I really don't want to play this one. But let's just, yeah, we have to play it. Actually, no, who did I play as last time? Was it Corbin? Yeah, Lulu and Corbin. Yeah, it's weird. I mean, wasn't the film based on, like, a French novel or something? I can't actually remember. Let's go with Corbin, actually. I'm assuming this is the same demo that was on the last one. Okay, I don't get this. Why is this in English? Because like I said, I'm sure this is based on like a French novel. And like this demo wasn't even released in the UK originally, so it's kind of weird. I think what happened was it's like they submitted this demo to be included on the UK disc. And the PlayStation magazine was like, fuck this, we're not going to even bother including it because it sucks. And you know what I gotta say? They have good reason to do so. Because, like I said, it's terrible. When it loads. Because I know the PlayStation, yeah, this is the same one. I remember, yeah, the PlayStation magazine said it sucked. And I gotta say, I really can't blame them. And, what the, oh. Yeah, I remember you gotta shoot the X button. Because, yeah. I kind of know how the controls work now. Now that I've had the chance to play the full version. And do you shoot this wings? I genuinely can't remember. Because I know you have to destroy something. I couldn't actually figure out what to do last time I played this. But I know you got to, like, destroy something. It's probably over here. So, no. Yeah, I remember that shit. I don't get why he even does that. Because, you know, it's like if you do that when you're, like, near an opponent, it basically gives them a free hit. And it's really kind of pointless. I mean, I guess it's like, oh, that was great. Just explodes by itself and I die. That's just brilliant. I call bullshit on that. Okay, what the hell is this thing? Because I think... Do you pick it up with circle, I think? Oh, okay, I guess I just pick it up by myself. Now I have a shield, I think. Or maybe a Oh, I don't know. I don't fully figure out how this game works. Like, I know the controls, but I don't know the game itself. No, what the... I pressed triangle. Again. I'm gonna say... And boy, does this game have tank controls. I know games like Team Red had it, but let me tell you now. Believe me, like, if you play this game, you will retract every bad thing you've ever said about Team Raider. That's all I'm going to say. Because Team Raider might have stiff controls, but this game is like, it's like a million times worse as far as the controls go. Can you jump with this? Because there's got to be something you got to destroy over here. But I'm not sure where it is. I mean, at least this demo has a timer on it. At least they gave me a bit of mercy there. Mercy. No, stop doing that. I don't want to do that. I want to kick the stupid... And there's a button to look around, isn't there? But I don't remember which... I don't remember which button it was. Maybe there isn't. Ah, okay, yeah. No, well, okay, I kind of want to quit, but I want to at least look at the controls first. Yeah, and this game was made by Callisto, who also made Nightmare Creatures. I mean, the controls in that game were pretty stiff. They're still way better than the controls in this game. It's ridiculous. So apparently there's no way to look. Great. Oh wait, no. Is it there, maybe? Hanging from ceiling. Protection, what? Oh, I guess that's, yeah, when you're in combat. There's a block, I guess, but I'm not sure. Good job, Callisto. So, there's got to be something around here I've got to shoot. And, yeah, I don't really care about the hell. Did he really move forward there? Because I have no idea. Why does this camera have to suck? Yeah. Because I know you've got to destroy something here. And if I remember correctly, there is no way to... there is no way to, like, look at where it is you're trying to shoot and just shoot it. I don't think there's a way to do that. It's like you got to find something that deactivates the stupid... You know, that thing that's getting in the way, the laser beams. But I don't know where it is here. It's like, you just gotta take a wild guess. Because, I mean, it's not this thing. And if I can get over here, is it that red light thing over there? No, I don't think it is, because... Okay, I have no idea what I'm trying to shoot. It's no wonder I couldn't figure out what to do last time, because it's so cryptic and stupid. I gotta say, as badly as this game sucks, the demo is even worse, because it's like, how are you supposed to figure this out first time? You can't. Okay, how am I supposed to get up here? It makes no sense. I really don't get it. How are you supposed to beat this? Can I jump on this ledge, actually? Maybe. Okay, that seems to work. I mean, I'm not even sure if you... No, okay, so apparently I can't go up there, even though I can clearly jump high enough to get up there, it doesn't let me. Because the controls suck. And I'm just going to say, like, it is, the controls are terrible. They really are. So if I try shooting this light, it doesn't do anything. Is it? Have I got to shoot that thing over there? No, it doesn't seem to work. I love that, he doesn't auto-reload or anything. Actually, I suppose that's probably... Do I fall down here, actually? No. So, I haven't got a clue what you're supposed to do at this point. I mean, someone will probably tell me in the comments. Like, oh, you're a complete fucking idiot for not figuring out how to... But I could figure out what to do to, like, beat the first level of this game. But I haven't got a clue what I'm supposed to do at this point. It's just confusing. And I also want to show off another problem with the controls. Like you crouch, and then as soon as you stop moving, he goes uncrouched. It makes no sense. Like, he does it every single time. It's like, why? He's like, how do I deactivate this? I have no idea. Okay, like... It's like you just have to take a wild guess. Oh, I don't want to jump again. I'm not a rabbit. I'm merely someone with terrible controls. Yeah. I don't think I'm really going to bother trying to get past this, because I can't figure out what to do. So, you know what? Let's just kill myself again, and quit because that sucked. I mean, it's pretty easy to see why they didn't include that on the UK demo back in 1998. You know, it's like, I mean, seriously, who bought that shit? I have no idea. But now we have Test Drive 5, and I seem to remember this one is pretty decent. I mean, I was never really a big fan of Test Drive, but I seem to remember this one's alright, actually. At least, like, the demo, anyway. But let's see. Wait, Accolade was still around in 1998? I thought they went out of business after Pupsy 3D. They should have done, because that game was shit. I mean, you know what's sad, though, is, like, as terrible as that game is, even that game's controls were better than the Fifth Element, and that really is saying something. Ooh, got some classic music right here. Is this Fear Factory, actually? I'm not sure. I have a feeling it probably is, but I could be wrong. But let's just go to a quick race. Okay, so we can play as the Aston Martin or TVR Cerbera. Let's go with the Aston Martin, because Aston Martins are awesome. Let's go with green. Oh. I kind of want to play that, actually, but I guess we can't. The Viper, because the Vipers are awesome. At least I think they're awesome, you know, with the stripes and everything. I like playing as them in Forza, so, yeah. Okay, let's do this. Yeah! I'm green, therefore I'm better than all these other drivers. Even though they're overtaking me somehow. Okay, I don't get this. Is it manual? Or... no, it can't be. Oh, shoot. Actually, what's the handbrake on now? Well, I don't know, but brake seems to work well enough, so I guess I'll just go with that. I hope I don't have to replace this music, because that would suck. Okay. And everyone's driving on the left, apparently. Actually, yeah, it's kind of funny. I mean, this was made by Pitbull, who also made, they also made Demolition Racer, which is a really awesome game, actually. I love that game. So I got it pretty recently, so I found it for pretty cheap. And it is, I gotta say, it's actually way better than Destruction Derby, I think. I mean, a lot of people probably disagree. I mean, a lot of people say Destruction Derby is, ooh, it's better. It really isn't, at least not in my opinion. Demolition Race is just, it's awesome. Oh, bugger. But yeah, it really is just, it's an awesome game. Because, you know, it's like Destruction Derby Raw, but it's like before Destruction Derby Raw, I think. Because I think Demolition Race was like 1999, if I'm not mistaken. And Destruction Derby Raw was released like just 2000. And it's, I don't know, I like Destruction Derby Raw, but I just don't like it as much as, you know, Demolition Racer. Oh, please let me make it to the next checkpoint, because I want to at least see if I can finish this race. Let me guess, is there going to be no checkpoints around here? Lame. Yeah, let's just quit out of that. No, what's it doing? Press start and select, so what the hell's going on now? So really don't need to look more at this. It always annoys me when you have games where it's like the timer runs out and then no, I don't want to watch the replay. I've never seen the point in like replays, and yeah, I kind of figure that. You don't need to tell me. Okay. Yeah, you really don't need to tell me I failed, because I kind of figure that from the fact that I ran out of time. Yes. 28 cars as compared to the like 100 or so that were in Gran Turismo. I can't remember the exact number, it was like 100 and something. Ooh! Okay, that was pretty loud. It's Christmas. Yeah. 16 Christmases ago. Or 15, or I'm not entirely sure how many. But yes, that was Test Drive 5. But now we have Tombi. And like I said, this one's going to take ages to play, because it's Tombi, and this demo is huge. It really is. It'd probably take like if I was to actually play through this whole thing, it would probably take like an hour. Okay, so we do get to play in English. That's pretty awesome. Let's do this. Let's indeed do this. Okay. But yeah, Tombi. As you can see, you got the controls right here. Pretty simple controls. Why did they move Tomba on the left? That's kind of weird. I mean, I know the American version of this was called Tomba, but still, it seems kind of weird. But yeah, I've got this game, and this game is awesome. You know, anyone that was kind of around back in 1998 and played this demo will pretty much be able to tell you that. But let's load this. Oh, here we go. Oh yeah, Whoopi Camp. Oh yes. Actually, I don't think they've really made any games, you know, apart from this and, you know, Tombi 2, obviously. Oh. So I got shit. Okay, I'm back. Actually, a couple of days have passed since that little interruption right there. Well, I say little, more like 2 days, but we'll start this up. Yeah, it's actually Wednesday right now. I mean, the last half an hour, I mean, that was recorded on Monday. But now I'm recording on Wednesday. I mean, I was going to restart the recording, but, you know, like, if I was to do that, then that would mean having to play the Fifth Element again, and, yes, yeah, sort that once is too many. So, yes. And, you know, I don't want to waste that half an hour of footage anyway. I mean, even though I failed hard at that game, you know, it's like, the game, it really doesn't deserve me playing it properly anyway, because, you know, like, if it was a good game and I was playing it, then, you know, playing it badly, then maybe I'll, you know, consider re-recording it if I had to redo the recording. But no, Fifth Element, no, the game doesn't deserve it. The game just flat out sucks. And I will not hear it, and I'm not going to hear any arguments to the contrary, because the gameplay sucks arse. But enough of that game, let's concentrate on this game, which is actually quite good. At least it would be if I could... Ah, wait, no, I want to get the... No, do you have to go in the back room area to get that? I think you do, actually. And, yeah, I know how to do that. So do this, and then, yeah, press X. And then, oh, nearly cost me a hit there. You also got those bird, you got that bird in the background, you gotta, like, steal all the chicks. And I'm just gonna do that, just to, you know, get out of the way. And yeah, I mean, I'm skipping through the text, I mean, it's not there's any voice acting or anything. And I'm not going to bother, you know, doing voices or anything like that, because it's really kind of, you know. Yeah. Oh yeah, I forgot the, yeah, circle to use that attack thing. So if we go here, it will trigger a little cutscene. Oh, no, doesn't it? Yeah, it does. Because I remember this. And then you look at what happens here, and, yeah, just a river. Although, to the right of where I am, like to the right of this house, it's incredibly foggy. It's, you know, it's worse than London. And that really is saying something, like, you see here. Yeah, clear the fog. Yeah, use an item, which I don't think I have it at the moment. I think you... No, I don't. But yeah, you press triangle to go into this menu. And yes, so hold up and jump, I can go into this background area. Ooh, wait, now if I jump on this one, it should work. Oh, no, I don't want... I want to get the egg. You know, smash the egg. And the chick. There we go. Chick acquired. I'm going to get this treasure... Oh. Oh, that's right, yeah, I need to get the key, don't I? I remember now. And if I sort this pig. Because the pigs are evil. At least in this game. Yeah. I mean, as you can see, I mean, it's pretty simple. In terms of, like, actual gameplay. Because you're basically just walking around and... Yeah, here we go. This is where we get the spell to get rid of the fog or, you know, the whatever it was. It'll come, yeah, furious tornado. That's what you have to do to get past the fog. Actually, no, I want to hit the platform, actually, because I think something happens. Oh, no, I don't want to do that. Oh, no. thought it would like knock them down or something, but I think I'm just remembering incorrectly. But if I go over here, get to the fog, and we can now get rid of it by using this. Wait, does it? And as you can see here, a tornado comes along and destroys all the fog. I don't know if tornadoes actually do get rid of fog, I haven't got an idea. But like I said, this one's going to take a while. I think you play like the first few areas of the game, like this is still the first part. And now we cleared the fog. I'm going to get this apple or tomato or whatever it is. Well, it's got to be a tomato, hasn't it? And it's red, it's got the thing on the top. Yeah, there we go. Actually, I wonder what happens if you miss, because I don't think I've ever done that. But I just wonder what happened. Do you just lose a life, or... Oh, little birds trying to assault me. Oh, bugger. Yeah, jumping out of the background like a twat. Actually, okay, I want to see if I can hit the bird with this thing. Oh, wait, no, it's in the foreground, I think. Great, and yeah, those tomatoes or whatever give you health. I'm sure it says in, you know, somewhere, probably the manual or something, what it is. And I'm going to save that because I don't need it. Actually, no, I remember if you try going this way to get to the next bit, you can't actually go this way. I think you have to... I can't remember. I think you have to go this way, because I think if you go by the, you try, you know, using those sticks or whatever, I think you just miss, but... I remember, like, one way you can go and one way you can't, and... No, I don't think you can access this bit in the demo, can you? I don't think you can. So, go to some guy over here. Yeah, like, see this guy. You wanna get past me? Yeah, and then you just fall in the water. Yes. I thought so. Yes. And... Yeah, well, I can't, so... Actually, I'm not sure, okay? I don't remember when you learned to swim. I don't know if it's in the demo or not, because I can't actually remember. But, you know what? I'm just gonna do what I can at the moment. Gonna get the rest of the chicks. I think there's four of them, isn't there? I seem to remember there was four of them. It's three or four. Not entirely sure. But we gotta go back here to get the other ones. And yeah, there's one down here, I think, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah. There's also a door here to the right. I don't think you can go there, though. No. Just give me the coin. Yes. I get those coins, even though, you know, it's... Oh, bugger. Yeah. Kind of messed that up. See if I can not mess it up this time. There we go. I think the blue ones give you, like, two hits, don't they? Yeah. Kill two birds with one bird. Or something. No, where are the other eggs? I can't save them. I know that there's got to be another egg around here, I think. I'm not sure. I seem to remember the wars, but, oh well. I don't remember which way I've got to go here. I've completely forgotten. Oh, okay, yeah, it's this way. If you try going the other way, you'll just slide down that, and you'll just mess it up. And as you can see, I've got one up, which is pretty awesome. It's very old school, this game, actually. Well, you know, it's quite old school. I mean, you know, like the graphics, I mean, your character's like a 2D sprite. It's pretty awesome. So, the stupid bird. Yeah, of course, it's too far away for me to actually hit him. He knows I can't hit him from there because he's a twat. Yeah, so you get. I'm gonna throw you off the. Oh, no, I guess you just gotta bounce off the fence. And get this thing. Yeah, the AP box. And so you have to get 50,000 points, or AP or whatever it is. Of course, I don't have 50,000 yet, so I can't really do that. So then we got the old man, or the boy's old man, or whatever. In fact, I think we get cutscene at this point, if I remember. Yeah, the 100-year-old boy's man, that's it. So as you can see, you know, we beat this. Mission, I guess. I mean, I'm not really sure what the right term is. A quest? A side quest? Or... Yeah, the red birds. Yeah, because I know... I seem to remember it was four of them, but I don't know where the fourth one is. Unless maybe there's only three, I'm not sure. Oh, okay, I guess there was. Because I thought there was another one where that second bird was. But there we go. Oh yeah, I remember this. Just pukes them out. As you can see, I beat that. And I think at this point he gives us a key, which you can use to open the treasure chest, from what I remember. Yes. Nothing to worry about. What else do I have to worry about? Because I don't remember. I don't think there's anything else to really do at this point other than get the stuff in the treasure chests, I think. I mean, this is just like the start area of the game. Oh, here we go. That's a cutscene right there. Okay. Yes, I'll be sure to do that. Okay. Actually, yeah, you just give us the key, I remember this. Oh yeah, that's right, you gotta get the bell, I don't remember. Yeah, that's right. I gotta say, like, as a kid, like, I didn't have this game when I was a kid, but I did play the demo, because, I mean, this was on, you know, Demo 37. And, yeah, the evil pig bags. Papa's got a brand new pig bag. Da-da-da-da. Sorry. That's the dwarf element. Yeah. Well, I know what that is. I don't remember if you have to get the treasure chest in the demo. I might just do it anyway, just to show it off, I guess. Yeah, because you see at this point you get a rope that sort of leads into the next part of the game. But you know what, we look at the inventory. 100-year-old key. No need using this. Hey, press the wrong button, I'm an idiot. I mean to press the circle. I keep pressing X for some reason. But if we go back here, gonna try opening. I'm sure you can open the treasure chest in this area with this, or at least some of them. I don't remember which ones though. Yeah, like this. I got the wings. I can't quite remember what those do actually, but I guess I'll look at those. And then try going back. I mean, I could try going back this way, but. Actually, you know, so let's try it. I'm probably going to regret saying that now, but, whatever. Yeah. Okay, I'm not entirely... Ooh. Okay, I'm not entirely sure how you're supposed to get those coins up there. Seems kind of weird. I know there's a treasure chest somewhere around this point. Oh, no, it's in the background, isn't it? Let's check. Let's just check it. Can we defeat this pig? And this one as well. Your pitchfork cannot stop me. Yeah, we can't open that one. But I remember there was another one that stopped the area. Oh. Oh, bugger. Show that again. See if I can... I gotta get through this. So I should make this. There we go. Yeah, because I remember you can jump far enough to make the ledges perfectly fine. And I want to go here. Yeah, I got the bell. So that's what, yeah, that's what you got to do. You got the bell, and then you've got to do that. Okay, you don't have to do that, but I just decided to do it anyway, because why not? But as you can see, it's kind of like a 2D platformer, but it's, you know, it's weird, and it's pretty awesome. It's got a lot of RPG elements to it, as you probably noticed by now. So let's make this. And then land on this guy, and then throw him, because he's a twat. And yeah, we can't open that one. Oh yeah, that's right, the enemy should spawn. That one that does kind of suck about this game. I mean, that's something that sucks about a lot of 2D platformers. It's like the enemies respawn. That's one thing they always hated about, like, Mega Man. It's like, you know, you like backtrack 2 centimeters, and all of a sudden the enemy respawns. It's annoying. I think that's one of the reasons I just didn't really care for the series that much, apart from like the second game for some reason. I don't know why. I really like the second game in the series, but the rest of them I don't know. I never really got into them. Oh, and okay, I got one. Nice. Me being an idiot there, but yeah, and I don't have that. I don't have the points for that. And I don't remember how many points getting the bell gives you. Let's read this actually. I mean, I've kind of been skipping through, you know, the cutscenes, but I mean, you can pause it. You know, you can pause the video if you really want to see what the text says. Yeah, and so we get this guy with the bell. See here. Is that where would it go? No, don't give him the bell at this point. Sure you do. Yes. So I remember that. Now just fly into space and that'll land again. Oh, actually, no. I think I'm missing something here. I think I've... Yeah. Actually, no, I want to look at the wings. Actually, I'm not sure. We've got to expect to. Oh, okay, yeah. Yeah, actually, use it there. And that just, yeah, that's. It's kind of common to have like Pokemon where you've got like, you know, when you have like a fly Pokemon that can just fly you to wherever you want to go. And yes, yeah, so let's just move on to the next area because. I'm already like, I've already played this for like 17 minutes. As I've been counting all the stuff at the beginning where he shows you the controls and all that. Like I said, this one, really long. And, but you know, I mean, it's a pretty awesome demo. So, run across here, continue to run across here, and then we jump for no reason. And then we jump on, oh, wait, no, we've got to wait for him to run away. Yeah, like you see, he's speaking like a foreign language, I guess. Yeah, you gotta learn dwarf language. And then we jump on this guy. And it's like every time you jump on him, you learn a bit of the language. I don't really know how that works. I mean, you know, if you could just jump on like a Chinese guy and just learn how to speak Chinese, that would be. You wouldn't even need to, you know, to learn like the classes and all that. But, yeah, you just keep jumping on him, and then you just learn the language, and, yeah. So then we go over this house. Where the hell's this guy got to? Oh. So, this bit reminds me of Super Mario Bros. 2, for some reason, when you've got, like, the desert levels, where you got wood jumping into the cacti, or walking into it. So, wait, oh, here he is. I was about to say, like, because you got to jump on it a third time. Yeah. What's this? Oh, okay, you can't look at that. So now if we go into the dwarf village. Went loads, of course. It's a problem with PS1. The load times kind of suck. Yeah, I think that's one thing that people, you know, that's one thing that's really good about, you know, N64. But as you can see, you know, we've gone to this, we've gone to this village that looks like some Final Fantasy. or, you know, whatever you want to call it. As you can see, now all of a sudden I can kind of speak it. Yes. Yeah, I remember what to do here. You go to the right, and then you jump on another guy. I think that's how this works. So I remember you can go here, and yeah, jump on this guy. Is that, I think it's that guy anyway. Yeah. So as you can see, now I've learned how to speak dwarf. So do you speak to this guy, or...? I don't quite remember. But yes, he kind of sort of tells us, like, what happened. As you can see, yes, the giant spores. And you got, like, yeah, the spores are just twat or something. Yeah, I mean, I kind of want to play through this whole thing, see if I can actually beat it, because, you know, it would take quite a while. But now we got to save the dwarves, and I remember you kind of got to backtrack at this point. You got to go back to the last bit that I was going through, you know, that forest. So I don't think there's any real point to going into the huts at this point, but I'm just going to do it anyway, just to be sure. And just to show off that you can do it. Yeah. I think that's just the place I was in. In fact, now let me look at the map. I don't remember what the button was. Oof, you have the correct button. So that triangle just goes to the item thing. Yeah, here we go. Pause the game. And bring all this stuff. So we go to status. As you can see, we've got the EXP. Also, that icon reminds me of Sonic, it really does. But we can actually switch between all this different stuff here. I don't know why you can't do that for pressing triangle, it seems kind of weird. But as you can see, these are the different things I've got to do. One bracelet's done with cum pigs. And we gotta save the dwarfs and. No, where's the dwarf elder? Meet the. I don't quite remember where he is. Is he in... Oh yeah, and AP points. I'm not sure if you could do that in the demo. I mean, obviously you can do it in the full game. I mean, that would kind of give it the same. But if we look at the map, kind of gives us an idea of, yeah. Because, I mean, you know, that bit on the, yeah, because you can just look at all these different areas. Because this bit down at the bottom, you know, bottom left, this is kind of the intro bit. And then we got this bit, and this bit that I'm in. Yeah, this bit. But, I'm trying to think of the one that I forgot. Yeah, because Dwarf Elder. Because I'm not sure if he's on the one that hurt, so if he was in that bit that I was just in. Okay, no one's in there. And then we've got this guy, I think, isn't this like a doctor or something? Yeah. And, let's open this actually. Oh, no, I don't think you can. So going back here, because I think I might have forgotten to do something at this point. So, yeah, we load here and we can... No, okay, we can't get back. Well, we can't go past that guy anyway. I think so. Yeah, God. I think you gotta save the dwarfs and then you can go past that, I think. I seem to remember it being something like that. And then if we go out here. I don't remember how many dwarfs there were. I think there were 5, if I remember correctly. I might check the event thing just to be sure. But I seem to remember there was 5 you have to rescue. Actually, no, I think it just says how many there are every time you rescue one. So we got this. Oh no, I want to throw it down to attack this guy. Yeah, because I remember they're always in the trees. And... Now let me do this. Okay, yeah, we've got a treasure chest up here. Now let me, I don't want to do that. I want to get on the treasure chest. That's what I want to do. Yeah, here we go. Got a boomerang. A wood boomerang, as opposed to all those, you know, as opposed to all the silicon boomerangs that you find. But, yeah. Gotta save the apple. No, tomato, sorry. This. I don't know what the hell I'm talking about, but I seem to remember all the dwarves that you gotta save. They're hidden in the trees. So you gotta be kind of careful. You gotta be, kind of watchful, I guess. Yeah, they're in the... Oh, wait, no, they're in these things. Yeah, that's it. Ooh. No, if I could... I'm trying to see if I can get onto the other one. Sorry, the one on... Yeah, here we go. So I forget if there's one up here. Oh, and there's this, but I can't open it, so it's kind of pointless. Actually, no, you can... No, I'm trying to figure out what to do here, because... I kind of remember what to do, but, yeah. Oh. I'm kind of messing this up. But yeah, you've got to look up here. I don't remember exactly how you, like, uncover them or whatever it is. I think, because I thought you could just jump on them, but I'm not sure. Oh, yeah. You jump on it and then they'll like fly out. As soon as you jump off it, I think that's what happens. So jump on this guy. No, we're bugger. If we try jumping on it. Get that. Tomatoes over there. No, stop respawning, you stupid twat. Yeah, nice try. How curious how many pigs does it take to ruin this... to ruin my game playing. Got a lot of luck swings. Yeah, there's another area after this, actually. Yeah, it does kind of bug me that the enemies respawn. Because that's one thing that I've never liked about, like, old-school platformers. I've always hated to do that. You know, it's like, why couldn't they just have it so that, like, when you kill an enemy, it stays dead? I've never understood, like, I never understood why games don't do that. Or, you know, most older games. It's like, obviously they want to make the game more challenging, but to me, it just always felt like, it just always felt kind of bullshit, I think. You know, it's just, like, an artificial way of making the game harder. I never liked it. Ooh, treasure. No, I want the treasure. Stupid. No. Get this way, you stupid git. And wings. Okay, here's where. Fuck you. This. Yeah. Okay, quit respawning, because I'm trying to get some. Actually. What's up? Oh, these pigs are all twats from the other side. It's like, oh, I'm gonna jump into you because I'm a git. How's about, yeah, fuck you. Oh, I want to get to the other area and not die in the process. Because there's another area you gotta get to, and then there's some more you gotta rescue there. And can you go? Okay, you can go in here. But I don't think there's really much of a point, if I remember. If we go here, hopefully, no, this is the other area you gotta go to. We got this dog. Yes. And, yes, no, and I've regained control. Actually, let's look at this, just to be sure. Wobbly wolf. Yeah, that sounds promising. Yeah, I remember this. For some reason, like, this area, it reminds me of Donkey Kong Country. Like all the bridges and stuff. And I think... No, there's one there. I remember having so much trouble beating this part, actually, because, like, some of these... I seem to remember, like, some of the ones are actually... Like, they're hidden in the trees, and... Okay, no, I can't hit that guy. Yeah, that's right, you gotta do that. Yeah, so, I seem to, is the thing on the left, maybe? No. Yeah, because I'm sure, at least later on, or, you know, at certain points, it's like, yeah. Okay, at least got my health back, that's something. Now we've got a bucket, and, actually no, there's another area around here. It's up to this guy. They're just not turned yet, can't really get any further. Yeah, as you can see, I physically can't get right. Yeah. Yes, try this again. So we go for here, and then we go for here, then we go for here. Try to avoid this thing. Then we jump and then we run that thing, or outrun it, or whatever. Yeah. As you can see, caterpillars with pig noses, that's weird. Pigs are evil! And, oh, I use this. I put Bark into the spores, I don't think we can get down. Okay, so we know we gotta save the dog as well. Ooh, if I could get on them in the first place. There we go. And then we've got this, and this. No, you stupid git. See, if it would just have like a finite amount of enemies and it just, as soon as you defeat them, they're just gone until you go back to the area. Okay, I can live with that. Oh, okay, so I actually did something there. Okay, I think I got that from like throwing the pig onto it. I don't think you're supposed to put yourself on that. It's like, no, that was bullshit right there. Yeah. So, they were spawned so regularly as well. It's like you just have to take a wild guess. And now I'm probably gonna die in a bit, because like you notice the camera only scrolls like when you land. It's just kind of annoying. And oh, I now got away with it there. I'm probably about to die, I think. Maybe. Yeah, and you can't jump on those things, but that kind of makes sense, really. And then we do the... Yeah. So I think I gotta go to the right. Actually, I should probably try to get back to the village, see if I can not lose all my health. This is going pretty badly so far. I know I'm missing something. Definitely missing something. Okay, so I can't panic if I hit this guy. Okay, and that didn't hurt him. What the hell? Okay, let me do this. I want to get the health. Oh yeah, that's right, there's something in here. Forgot about that. I forget I made the wrong the other bit. I think there's three, but I'll get rid of all these ones to be sure. Because I don't want to like miss one here and then have to do all this again. Or go through all this bit. Yeah, so there's one. I think there's two hidden in the other area. Because I'm for sure there's something there at least. And, okay, there's some health, there's nothing as well, yeah. So now we've got to go to the other bit, I can't actually remember what it was called, but it's the other bit, you know. It's that bit that's over to the other bit. And then we go up here, go through this door, and we will end up, it loads. You'll end up here. And I remember this bit is kind of annoying, because you got these platforms, you got these weird spider things that try to kill you. And okay, apparently I can't jump on that guy. I think you could jump on I think you have to jump on them when they're not there. And these platforms are kind of annoying. because it's like you gotta line them properly. And it, at this point, it's not really much of a problem, but it's like you get later on, it's kind of awkward, like this bit. Because you got all this shit to avoid. And again, the enemies constantly respawn. So it's like, yeah. You can't really make it much easier. And, okay, there's a guy to rescue here. So I got to try and hit this, but as you can see, that there's not much range on it. That's the problem with this attack, there's just not much range to it. So, see, I've got to hit it here, if I can. So there we go, that works. And then we go up to this. And I think I seem to remember the ball droppers hurt you if they land on you, if I remember correctly. As you can see, one dwarf remaining, so nearly done with this bit, thankfully. I'm not sure if, I think this is like the last bit of the demo, if I remember correctly. I don't think there's any other bits after this. In the demo, obviously, I mean, obviously the full game is quite long. It's a lot longer than this, but you probably figure that. I mean, if you could beat a whole game in half an hour, that'd be... On the PS1, it'd be pretty terrible. I mean, on a NES, it's probably not so bad. I mean, there's a lot of games on there you could beat in, like, half an hour. If you're good at them. I mean, if you're not good at them, then... Oh, okay, the droppers don't hurt you. Never mind. And then we gotta traverse up this. That green thing, which I'm not gonna get buff with. So we gotta rescue this. Oh, and I missed. Oh well, I got that. I think we're done. And I seem to remember there's another guy that blocks you from getting to the next area if you don't have all the dwarfs. It seems I have all of them. It really doesn't matter. So I'm gonna get rid of this guy just to make this next bit a little bit easier. And oh wait, no. Oh wait, no, it doesn't spin that way. Bugger. Yeah, there we go, that works. But, now we gotta go up here. Go with this guy, because he's a twat. I think you can climb up this bit. I don't remember if there's any real point to it, but I'm just gonna do it anyway. No, there's nothing up here. Yeah. Oh, come on, I landed on him. That was bullshit hit detection right there. I seem to remember there's like some stuff you can get down here, but I don't want to risk it because, I mean, I can't really see where I'm going if I try to go down there. So it's, yeah, I'll probably just keep failing at it, and you know, it would take a lot longer than it really needs to. And I can't open this thing. I know that much. And we talk to this guy. Oh, do I have to go back to the village first? Do that just to. I'll do that and then I'll probably come back here if that doesn't end the demo. So let's jump down and. Oh wait, no. Okay. No, it's this bit. Collect all this stuff and then we fall back down and I got a crystal ball. And. Oh wait, no. That's not it. Yeah, this is it. And so we go back to the village, and it should say that we rescued all of them, because, you know. Oh, because I did. And, yeah, as you can see now, they're all just standing around the middle. Just talk to this guy for no reason. Seeing a small child, he went to go look for the flower seeds and hasn't come back. As you can see, now we've got that to do. There's a lot of stuff to do in this game, as you can probably tell. And now I'm getting the way this guy's walking animation, or walking cycle, or whatever. They just kind of like just walk in place until you move out of the way, which is kind of funny. But I don't remember what to do at this point to actually end the one that I'm trying to end. I think it involves going here, but I'm not entirely sure. Yeah. So as you can see, now I've saved the dwarfs. Now I've got another 5,000 points, or your AP, or whatever. The child is still missing. I'm not sure where the child is, I can't remember. It's up to this guy. On the FIFA court. Who is he? Yeah, and you see that guy in the background with the beard? That's the dwarf elder, I think. I mean, it should be. And also, I remember you can get a... You can get some, like, purple trousers or something around this point in the game. But I don't remember exactly what you do to get it. I just remember you can do it, and I'm pretty sure you can have it at this point. But I just kind of forgot. So let's check the events again. And if we look... See, we've still got... See, I mean, this and this one. I don't think you can actually complete those in the demo. I think it's just this. I think it's just the stuff on the first page you can do. So yeah, we're risking lost child. Yeah, so as you can see, in the forest. So just gotta check that area. And look at the EXP. Because EXP is important in these, basically anything that has RPG elements. Is there someone in this house now? Let's check. Actually, I thought there was something you could do in here. And, oh yeah, that's right, you can run with square in this area. I forgot about that. Saved everyone? Thanks a lot. Okay. That's my one. Actually, was it something to do with the well? No. Can't go in it. Meet the elder? No, because I haven't... I can't do that yet. I still gotta save the kid, and there's like a puppy I gotta rescue, but still gotta load. Okay, so as you can see, now we've got. Let's check. Let's leave no stone unturned, just in just in the off chance that it's in this bit of the beginning, which it won't be, but yeah, may as well just get it out of the way just to say I did it, because I am the best. I am the best. I am the best. West swag. Whatever it is. You know that song on YouTube? Where you just got a bald guy standing on top of a car or something? I like that video. It's like watching 90s shows because I'm so fucking awesome. Like, speaking of 90s shows, I mean, Kin and Kill. That was a classic show. Yes. I mean, I wonder what happened to Kel. So I know Keenan's working on Saturday Night Live. I don't remember what else he did. I know he's in a film. I can't remember what film it was, though. I really can't remember. I mean, it was like a Hollywood film. I don't remember which one. And the kid's got to be in this area, hasn't he? It's not this guy. Yeah. And yeah, you got the dog hidden in the trees. It's got to be this area, actually. So I really can't imagine where else it would be. I think there's just some health, if I remember. Or at least there was some health, but... Because the health doesn't respawn, even though the enemies do. And that kind of bugs me. I mean, I think it respawns if you die, but, you know, it's still kind of stupid. You know. I mean, like I said, this game is very old school, and that's not always a good thing, you know. Because there's plenty of things about, you know, really old school games that I just don't like. And yeah, there is the dog, as you can see. As you can see, I rescued it. Actually, no, do I have to get... No, I'm sure I can rescue the kid as well. And get back with the property. I think that's how it works. Let's jump on all these things until I find this kid. He's got to be, like, right at the end of the forest. If I remember correctly. I don't think there's anything else at the bottom. And, yeah, this twat gets in the way. Yeah. I wanted to jump on him, but I didn't want to jump over him. Okay, I jumped on him. That was bullshit. Bullshit detection right there. What the fuck? Okay, I messed that up. I probably better to mess up even more. I think. And what the hell is this kid? Okay, I have no idea. And yeah, you can't get back on that thing, so it just bounces. So, you know, here's where I hit this guy. And I hit this guy, and I hit this guy. Oh yes. Just, where the hell is this kid? I can't remember. And if I can't find him, then I'm not going to bother looking for him, because, you know. Unless he's in the other area. I mean, oh, no, I don't want to bounce off that. I want to, you know, jump on it. By that song, you know. Aperture, jump on it, jump on it. Yeah, thankfully the dog spawns at the place. And, yeah. You know what I mean. So I think I have to rescue this first and then go back. If I'm not mistaken. I don't really see how else you would do it. We gotta go through all this. What's the trouble to rescue the dog? Even the RSPCA didn't have violent pigs going around assaulting them while they're trying to rescue dogs. I'm just saying. I'm serious, like 45 minutes into this. It's ridiculous. So where am I supposed to have a dog? I don't know. It's up this guy, I don't think. Is it this bit? It should be. I think it's the guy on the left I have to talk to. No. Where the hell's the dog gone? No. I think I messed this up. Because I went to the wrong bit. And I don't know which bit I'm supposed to go... I'm supposed to go to. Because apparently the dog's buggered off. Or... No, I can't really tell. I don't know where to bugger off to. It better not be in the forest, because that'd be stupid. It'd be a stupid idea. If it has, I'm just going to quit, because... no, I think... Wasn't it there? I just walked past it. I mean, I'll check, but... I mean, seeing as I have to load it again, that'd just be kind of annoying. Yeah. So let's try to get back to... No, the help. Have I got to talk to a specific person or something? Because I don't remember. I don't remember what I got to do here. See, because... Yeah, see right here. Do a problem. Oh, what is that? Okay, I don't know. I don't remember which one you have to talk to, so... It's gotta be one of these. Yeah, this... No. No, I got the puppy. And yeah, it's not on the items, so... See, I mean... Unless I gotta talk to someone else. Try going to the people on the... whatever. See, I don't remember... No, I'm gonna talk to the other one. Yeah, I guess I can't talk to them. See, I know I'm probably screwing this up really badly, but yeah, it's like I can't remember like what I'm supposed to do to end the puppy mission. It's because I'm obviously doing something wrong here, because otherwise I wouldn't be having this much trouble just trying to end it. Bro, is this it? Okay, so I think. Yeah, okay, so I think I've beaten it now. I think... okay, so I think... It's too dangerous to go there now. So we gotta get the herbs. Okay. See how long this demo is? I mean, it's insane. It's insane that you play for this... Oh, okay, I nearly knocked out the... No, I did knock out the... Fuck the stupid recording device. It's like, it's annoying that I have to plug it right into the front of my computer, so, like, what? So as soon as my foot knocks against it, it, like, stops detecting it. And I think the program's probably going to be a twat and say that it's not detecting it. Okay, here we go. Yeah, I kind of messed up there. Hopefully it's still recording fine. It seems to be. Yeah, it is. Okay, I've got the points I need for the AP thing. I might go back there. Of course, I can't get any more health because I've lost all of it. I used all of it because the stupid pigs. And I don't remember where the herbs are. This is where it gets a bit sketchy, I think. That's the right word. Now you can climb that ball, can't you? Yeah. But I don't remember where the herbs are. It's kind of annoying, because I want to... Yeah, I have to get them. And then jump up this, and then... I'm not sure if the guy lets us past. I mean, he should do, because I rescued the villagers. Yeah, get out of my way. Let's talk to him. No, what the... Okay, they... No, they... Oh. Yeah, it's still got to rescue the kid, I think. I think... Yeah, of course, can't jump on the ladder and then start climbing. No, you gotta climb the whole thing. Even though, like, most NES games, you could do that. But apparently this game, you can't. This is you climb here. And what is this? Telescope. Okay, so I guess I did that. Wait, no, I don't want to look at this. I want to, look at the... No, I think I do want to look at the items, actually. Let's just look at the events, just to be sure. Yeah. So now we've got... Yeah, enjoy the view. I mean, look at all these objectives. It's ridiculous. Yeah. He wants to go down. That's not... I want to see if I'm missing something here. Because obviously I can't destroy that. Let's just pop the scenery. Oh, give me that health. No, oh, I completely messed that up. The hell am I doing? Oh, why can't you just go away and just, you know, just disappear as soon as I kill you? I mean, I know it's something I keep complaining about, but still, it just has to be said. It's a problem that has to be addressed. Or, not necessarily a problem, but it's just something that bugs me personally. Okay, I wanna... No, it's the... I forget if there's, like, a spike pit at the bottom or... Not necessarily a spike pit, but, like, it hurts you. If I remember if it... Okay, it's not this bit. And, yeah, this twat doesn't go through. So I wanna go to the, you know, the bit at the back, but... Can I climb on... No, I don't remember where you're supposed to go back, actually. Okay, and okay, no, I want the stupid thing to go up. Okay, and then we want to go up here, and we want to go here. I've got my health back at least, but I'm kind of lost on what to actually do. I mean, trying to play this demo is like a whole game in itself, just trying to beat everything. Okay, and I'm not sure how do we get into that bit. Okay, I don't know how to get to that. Yeah, that spore thing. There's gotta be a way to do it. But I just can't remember how. Oh, yeah. Just blindsided me right there. Nearly got hit. Suppose I gotta wait for this idiot to move out of the way. Okay, what am I missing here? So obviously I'm missing something, but I don't know what. Is it? No, it can't be the green coin. Because that's just like points. Oh no, I'm probably not going to be able to beat this. Oh no, I'm probably going to quit it in a bit, because... I'm kind of lost on what to actually do at this point. And maybe I've got to go to that other bit. Let's try that, actually. I think this is... Yeah. This is where the trousers are. I want to equip those. No, I pressed the wrong button. Oh, wait, no, I did press the right button. Yeah, because that uses it. I pressed X, so... So, for a second there, I was thinking I've kind of messed up. But I don't know if I already have to use those at this point. I can't remember, because obviously they help with you jumping, but maybe I do have to use it. Let's just try going to the other bit first. So as you can see, I always find it funny that it's like, you know, on like the cover of the game is like wearing the green ones, even though, you know, from what I remember, like most of the game you don't. You wear these purple ones because obviously they're better. You can jump better with them. Or, you know, a little bit better at least. So wait for the... Oh. Yeah, it's going to start rolling. I just want to make sure I didn't get hit by it. Yeah. I don't remember if I can get past this point. I can't remember. Oh wait, no. I just want to go up here first. Go here, talk to this guy. No, I can't. Yeah, I'm kind of stuck. Yeah, I think I'm probably just going to quit at this point because I've forgotten what to do here. So, yeah, it kind of sucks that I wasn't able to beat it, but, you know. I mean, like I said, it is a really long demo. And... No, doesn't it go back to the menu? Or... Oh, okay, it goes back here. I could have sworn it just goes back to the menu when you're done with it. But I guess... Unless maybe this is like a different version or something. But I mean, I'd literally spend like an hour on just this game. I mean, that's just ridiculous right there. I mean, imagine if I came across, like, a demo of this game and, like, Populous on the same disc, it would take forever. Anyway, now we're done with the playable stuff, let's move on to Everybody's Golf, which is a video. I've got this game, actually. It's a pretty good game. Although, I gotta admit, I pretty much got this one entirely because of the cover art, because the cover art is just... It's just hilarious. I mean, just look it up. It's like a golf ball. It's like, oh! And yeah, this has got to be the same video that's on Demo 37, because I mean, it's in English, and yeah, pretty familiar music, except it kind of sounds different. Yeah, and it's like that music that plays on those Net Yaroze videos. Oh yes. Classic music right here, actually. I don't think I actually watched this video as a kid, because I was like, yeah, it's a golf game, and I don't really care about it. That was my thought, like, at the time, anyway. But it's a pretty good game, actually. I mean, I still don't really care much of golf games, but this is one that I will play. This and, you know, those Mario golf games. I mean, I've got one on the Game Boy, actually. It's a pretty good game. But yes... I mean, I know there was a sequel to this on the PS1. I don't have it. I think I would have played a demo of it, but I don't remember. Yeah. Because Everybody's Golf, as opposed to someone else's golf. I guess it was like, you know, this is golf, and it's not just for like people that are really into the sport. Like, you can play it as well, because... It's kind of weird or something. I mean, it's not really weird, it's just, you know, kind of more simplistic, I guess, than, you know, like Tiger Woods or whatever. Anyway, Spyro the Dragon video. Actually, is it still called Tiger Woods? Because I know there's a whole, like, you know, controversy with him, like, sleeping with someone else back in, like, 2010 or something. And then it's kind of like, you know, yeah, I recognize this. Spyro the Dragon video. Classic right here. And I'm pretty sure this got based on like a beta version of the game. We'll see, I guess. Yeah, because we've got the flying levels right here. And got, I think that's like the first one, isn't it? And then we got this. And then we got this guy who's a twat. And then we got, yeah, second area and 10 square, whatever. Yeah. They're going through the stuff quite a lot, actually, so it's kind of hard to, like, say all these levels. But I think they're just kind of like, gradually going through the whole game, I think. Well, actually, no, I was about to say that's, like, the first flying stage, but I think that's the second one. I mean, I'll be honest, it's been a while since I tried to play through the whole game. I mean, it really is. I mean, I should probably try playing through all these games again, like Spyro. I mean, like, I played for the third one pretty recently. I mean, I didn't, you know, do video on it or anything. I just kind of played through it. And it's an awesome game. I haven't really bothered playing the ones after the PS1 games. Like, I've only really bothered with the original games. I mean, I think I've got, like, a demo on the PS2 that has one of the other Spyro games, but I haven't really bothered to play those yet, just because I haven't really felt like it. I might do videos on those in the future, because I've got, like, three of those discs. And there's one that I actually kind of want to play, just because of some of the games that are on it. But yeah, Spyro the Dragon, awesome game. And actually, I think it's just the Neturalty stuff left, isn't it? If I'm not mistaken, yeah, because we've got Push 2 and then we've got Neturalty video. I'm gonna do the video first, because I'm pretty sure you have to reset the Neturalty game, and I don't want to do that, because that'd just be like a waste of time having to reset the game. And yeah, I can get through this pretty fast. So I'm assuming this is in French, but we'll see. Neturalty, yeah, La PlayStation de Development. Pretty cool seeing this in French, actually. I mean, it's different, kind of. It's always the same video, though, on the English discs. It's just... That's why it's, like, between, like, you know, demo, like, 10, volume 2, all the way up until, like, 41. It's just the same video every month, pretty much. Yeah, Comment Le Marche. Un PlayStation 1 multi-format, or something. And then they actually bothered translating this bit, which is kind of weird. Telephone connection, yes. And all this. I mean, look at all the amount of stuff you got connected. It's ridiculous. And, yeah. Here's Pushy 2. Just a game that I'm going to be playing here. And Psycom, which is a really awesome game. I kind of wish that game was on here, but it isn't. Actually, it was actually on Demo 37, like, it actually had two games that month, because you know, the demo that came out before that one was, like, a Tekken 3 demo. I have no idea why they did that. It really made no sense to me, you know, because, I mean, Tekken 3 is an awesome game, but, I mean, did it really need its own demo? I don't think it did. I'll say that much. Maybe as you can see, still the same registration office, that's kind of weird. I guess I didn't bother having any of the ones. It's only the UK, I guess, but still. But yes, contact those people. I very much doubt you can contact them now. I think if you were to do that now, you'd just say, yeah, you wouldn't really get a response. But we've still got one thing left, and that is Pushy 2 or Pushy 2B or whatever. Oh, well, that's in English. That's kind of weird. But yeah, we got to reset the console. And I'm not going to do that, because this is the last thing on the disc. At least, yeah, here we go. Now load in, and what point does eventually load, as you can see. I don't really know why they use this menu for these, you know, like earlier on, because I mean, there's only one game on here, it's kind of pointless, and apparently it loads slowly, which kind of sucks. I don't like it with load slowly, because that's just like wasting time and stuff. And as you can see, it's loading pushy2.psx. That's great. And I remember what this game is. I don't think I've played it on anything else, but I do remember what it is. And when it eventually loads, we'll see what this is. I don't remember it taking this long to load. Yeah, here we go. Written in 20 weeks. Yeah, fishnet, whatever that is. I mean, just listen to the sound effects on this. Actually, let's look at the credits. Yeah, everything by R. Fred W, whoever that is. Start the game. I mean, what is up with the sound effects on this? Just sound effects on this are really weird. But the game itself, it's basically Sokoban, or whatever it's called. Is it called, like, Boxel, I think, on the Game Boy? I mean, I only played the Japanese version on the Game Boy because I had those, like, your bootleg carts where they always put that on there. And, yeah, this is just like it. And I'm ready to beat this. I didn't really beat this game as a kid, I just, you know, I just kind of like played it up until like, you know, the first dozen levels, and then I just kind of got bored of it. Because, you know, there's only so much you can do with this, and I really don't understand the sound effects, like the company music. Instead it's got beep, 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 beep. It's like, what the hell's going on? And you also notice like all of the levels are just like people's names. It's funny because like you can literally just enter like random names into the password system and like get to a later level. It's weird. In fact, I might try that after I'm done with the next couple of levels right here. I'll probably play the next couple of levels and then I'll just like enter some random names in. But we do this. Go all the way around, so the Buffalo Girls go around the outside apparently. And then we've got this level, which is kind of annoying from what I remember, because you got to do this. I mean, what am I even playing as anyway? Am I playing as like a beanbag with eyes or something? I don't know. But we got to move this around, it's kind of a pain in the arse. I mean, there's another game that plays like this called, I think it's called Pandora's Box. But that one was like 3D and you didn't have like these pieces at the side of it by themselves. That one's kind of more annoying to play from what I remember because you can't really see the whole board at once. And you see, like even as well as I'm doing, I don't really get many points for that. And yeah, I'm kind of done with this because I just want to... I think quitting just... Yeah, it goes back here. And if I enter a password, you can literally just... Oh, yeah, this is kind of a pain in the arse. Yeah, let's just enter... Let's just put in Ronnie. Seeing as that's my YouTube name, kind of. Let's try that. Okay, that didn't work. Actually, I was going to say Robert, but... I mean, Rob was one of the last names, so it's... Let's go one... This has got to be a level. This has got to be a level. Michael. The Michael Rosen rap. You may think I'm happy, you may think I'm sad, you may think I'm crazy, you may think I'm mad, but just do the... Yeah, so that worked. And now I'm on... Okay, now I'm on this level. Pew! Okay, I'm not sure what to do here, actually. I think I might struggle with this one. But yeah, as you can see, now I'm just skipping to like a random level later on in the game. I think I might have messed this up, actually. I never actually got this far when I played it before. So I'm not sure what to do here. As you can see, I've completely messed this up. Yeah, we should quit out of this. Start select. And it should go back here. Yes. So, yeah, that was Euro Demo France 24. It's not a bad demo for the most part. I mean, most of the game's pretty good. I mean, Tombi is a really good game. Circuit Breakers is alright. I mean, it's not a great game, but I mean, you know, it's interesting that you can, like, use this demo to, like, get bonus tracks and whatever. Test Drive 5 is alright. ISS Pro is pretty good, as far as those football games go, at least. Ghost in the Shell's really awesome. The only bad thing about this disc is that the Fifth Element is a piece of shit. And is one of the worst games I've ever played on PS1. But you know, it's a pretty good demo apart from that. And yes, I will see you later, people. See you.